Alright, I showed in a previous video and discussed what a rational expression is. A rational expression is simply just a fraction, but not just any kind of fraction like 1/2 or 3/5 or something like that, but it's fractions that have variables in them as well. Alright, so it's fractions with variables. And the way to simplify any rational expression is to factor. Alright, that's going to be the key. In fact, I'm going to put that up here right now. Factor is the name of the game when it comes to simplifying rational expressions. Let me show you what I mean. For example, if you had something like, say, 8 m to the 5th over 2m squared, something like that, and we had to simplify this rational expression. What I'm going to show you, first of all, is something called factoring, and I'm going to show you why we factor as well, okay? So if you're okay with this, I'm going to rewrite both the numerator and the denominator. I'm going to rewrite them. And watch how I rewrite this. See that 8 right there? I'm going to rewrite it as 2 times 2 times 2. Right? And m to the 5th simply means m times m times m times m times m. It really means 5 m's being multiplied together, right? And on the denominator, I have just a single 2. That's this guy here. And I've got m squared. Hey, that means m times m. All right, so what I did was I took my original rational expression, and using factoring, I wrote them all out as factors. All right, the entire numerator, the entire denominator, wrote as factors. Now, there's this rule in math, right? There's this property in math that says, look, anytime you have a number up top that is exactly the same as a number on the bottom, you can cross them out. You can cross them out. Why is that? Well, think about this, right? If you have 2 on top and 2 on the bottom, any number divided by itself is always a 1. Right? So that's one. That's a property in math that's called the inverse property, if you haven't learned that yet. But that's called the inverse property. And the other thing, too, is if you multiplied 1 times anything, does it change? No, it stays the same, right? So 1 times anything doesn't change. So really, essentially, when you cross these out, we say they cross out or they cancel each other out. They really, I hope you understand, turn into just a fancy 1. That's it. That's all it is. And 1 times all of this other stuff isn't going to change it. It remains the same. By the way, 1 times anything, identity property. Okay, is there anything else we can cross out that cancels out, so to speak? Yeah, look, these m's can go. These m's can go. All right, so what we're left with in the numerator is 2 times 2, which is 4. We've got 1, 2, 3 m's, so that's m to the 3rd. And that's it, right? We have nothing left in the denominator. Everything crossed out down below. And that's our final answer. Now, one more thing I want to mention before I show you another example, and that is this. When I factored this 8 m to the 5th and I wrote it this way, do you notice that each of these things, right, what was going on in each of these little terms up here, so to speak, is that I was multiplying them all, right? All of these factors were being multiplied together. Same thing down here, look, that was times, right, 2 times m times m. So it's important to know that multiplication must be going on up top. It looks like a bunch of moms, doesn't it? Right, multiplication must be going on up top and in the denominator. And the reason that I can cross things out, guys, is because division, that big old fraction bar, and multiplication are opposite operations. That's what allows me to cross things out. Okay, let me show you another example of what I mean here. How about, let's see here, try this problem out. Scoot that down. Okay, how about this one here? Different problem now. I've got 7m plus 14 over 5m plus 10. All right, so let's try this one out. Let's simplify this down. Now, again, I've seen people do this in class. They say, hey, look, I see an m on top and an m on the bottom. Let's cross them out. No, hold on, right? Or 14 and 10, look, two goes into both 14 and 10. We can start crossing them out and simplifying them down. Hold on. Do you see that in this problem, there's addition going on up top, right? Look, and there's addition going on the bottom. And addition does not undo that division bar there. So the first thing we should do, keep this in mind, is we've got to factor. See that? Factor is the name of the game here, okay? So let's factor it. Let's forget about the denominator for a second. Let's factor the numerator. What do those two terms have in common? 7. And if you take it out, if you factor it out, what's left? M plus 2. Right? Put it back in. 7 times m, 7m. 7 times 2, 14. All right, let's do the same thing on the bottom. What do these two terms have in common? A 5. Take it out. What's left? M plus 2. And now do you see anything that is exactly the same on top in the numerator, that's the same as the bottom denominator, that we can cross out? Yeah, hopefully you can see, look, the M plus 2s are exactly the same. We can cross those out. Now, why can we cross them out? Because, look, it was 7 times this stuff, and it was 5 times that stuff. And now that it's written as multiplication, that will undo this division right here. Okay, that's what allows me to cross things out. Final answer is 7/5. Isn't that pretty fun? All right, let me show you just two more quick examples, and then I'm done with this video here. How about something like this? How about this one here? I've got... Let's see if you can recognize this as well. M squared minus n squared over m plus n. Yeah, that's a good one. Okay. Hopefully you will soon, if not already, be able to recognize this stuff up top. Oh, by the way, let me back up. Don't start crossing anything out right now. Do not start crossing anything out. Look, there's addition going on. There's subtraction going on. They do not undo, right? There's subtraction up there, addition down there. They do not undo that division in the middle, okay? So before we do anything else, guys, before we do anything else, we must factor. That is the name of the game, all right? Factor is the name of the game. Does anyone recognize that numerator? I hope you do by now. Look, that is a difference of squares. And a difference of squares can be factored just like so, right? Where the two parentheses look exactly the same, except the signs in the middle are different. All right, we still have an m plus n on the bottom, and now I hope you see that we can cross things out, right? Look, this is stuff times stuff, and because that's multiplication, that's what allows me to cross out these m plus n's, and I'm left with just m minus n. Now, take a look at this answer here. You can write this answer with the parentheses, m minus n, this stuff right here. You can write this with the parentheses or without the parentheses. In fact, I like it without, because since there's nothing else going on up top, it's just m minus n, we don't really need these parentheses anymore. Okay, we're just going to write it without. I think my math lab will take it if you're using my math lab with the parentheses. Doesn't matter. All right, last example here. Take a look at this last example. This is a big one. How about say something like this? AC minus AD plus BC minus BD all over AC minus AD minus BC plus BD. Now, before you start getting all cross happy, you know, start crossing stuff out, all right? Remember that the name of the game is factor. All right, we have to factor first, put things in a form where there's multiplication going on, right? Put things in a form where there's multiplication going on. So, let's see. Hey, since I see four terms up top, this must be one of those grouping type of things, right? Let's group the first two, and do you notice that they both have an A in common? Taking it out leaves me with C minus D. How about these guys? What do they have in common? Positive B. And if we take that out, we're left with C minus D. Right. I'm going to do a little bit more to that numerator, but let's keep going. Let's group these guys in the denominator. Hey, these guys both have an A, leaving me with C minus D. And these guys both have a, watch this now, these both have a negative B, leaving me with C minus D. Let me just double check this last one. Ready? What's negative B times C? Negative BC. What's negative B? Oops, negative B times negative D. Ooh, that's a positive BD. Yep, so we know we factored correctly. Okay, well, there's one more thing you hopefully you can see, that these terms up top both have a C minus D in common. You see that? They both have a C minus D in common. This is called factor by grouping, C minus D. And if I take it out, I'm left with A plus B. Good. Okay, and over here, likewise, I can take out the common factor, which is C minus D. It's got some stuff in it. And I'm left with A minus B in the other parentheses. And now can you see that I've got them in a form, right? I've got all this shrunk down in a form where I have multiplication going on up top. Look at this. This is C minus D times some stuff, and C minus D times some other stuff. So that's what allows me to cross these guys out. And my final answer is, I'll write it just like this here. I've got a plus b on top and a minus b on the bottom. And stop right there. Don't go any further. Now, I know a lot of my students are tempted when they see this. Hey, Poyser, we can cross out these a's. No, don't do it. Don't do it. Again, keep in mind, you can only cross things out if multiplication is going on up top. Right? That's addition. Subtraction. Can't do it. Stop right there. This is our final answer. Okay? Stop here. That's the answer. Hope that helps.